Hello everyone, I welcome you to today's webinar. We look forward to working through some important information about payroll tax and your reconciliation with you. The training and development team would like to acknowledge the traditional custodians of the Budjara we are on, the Wujak Noongar people. We extend this acknowledgement and our respects to the traditional custodians wherever you may be. We thank them for sharing this beautiful Budjara on which we learn and grow. Their connection to the land, waters and communities began in the Dreamtime and continues today. We give our deepest respects to all Elders past and present across all Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander nations. This is just a general disclaimer that these notes have been prepared by Revenue WA as a guide to understanding the legislation. The relevant legislation remains the ultimate source of authority on any matter. Let's look at the agenda for this presentation. The duration will be approximately 45 minutes. First, we'll look at what payroll tax is, review the different employer types and the payroll tax thresholds and rates. We'll also briefly go through how the diminishing threshold works and the key dates for lodgement of returns. Then it's all about the annual reconciliation. Today's webinar will be for taxpayers who are eligible to use the end of year function in Revenue Online. Eligible client types include interstate non-group employers who lodge annually, monthly and quarterly, designated group employers of interstate groups who lodge annually, monthly and quarterly, and designated group employers of local groups who lodge monthly and quarterly, but not annually. We'll go through the steps involved and what you need to lodge. We'll also be displaying some screens from our system, Revenue Online or ROL, so you can get a clear understanding of what information you need to provide in the June return and annual reconciliation. Finally, we'll show you where to get more information, such as publications on annual reconciliation and YouTube videos. So, what is payroll tax? It is a tax assessed on taxable wages paid by an employer. Payroll tax is collected by Revenue WA for the Western Australian Government. The revenue raised by payroll tax is paid into the consolidated fund of the state to meet the costs of public services such as education, health, public safety, and law and order. The calculation of payroll tax varies depending on your employer registration status and frequency of lodging returns. An employer will be categorised and registered as one of the following: non-group employers and group employers. As you can see, there are also two subcategories, local and interstate. I'll go through each of these in turn. A local non-group employer pays wages only in Western Australia and the employer is not a member of a group. A local group employer is grouped with at least one other wage-paying entity and all members of the group pay wages only in Western Australia. An interstate non-group employer pays wages both in WA and at least one other Australian jurisdiction, and the employer is not a member of a group. An interstate group employer is grouped with at least one other wage-paying entity and pays wages in Western Australia. At least one member of the group pays wages in another state or territory. Every employer listening today will fall into one of these categories. Now let's take a look at the thresholds and rates for the 2023-2024 financial year. The annual threshold amount in Western Australia from 1 July 2020 is $1 million, and the monthly threshold amount is 1/12 of this annual amount, which is $83,333. From 1 July 2023, the payroll tax rate is 5.5% of the taxable wages paid by all employers or groups of employers whose taxable wages are above the annual threshold of $1 million. If you or your group's taxable wages are below the annual threshold of $1 million, then you're not liable for payroll tax. WA uses a diminishing threshold method. This means a tax-free threshold gradually phases out for employers or groups of employers with annual taxable wages in Australia between $1 million and $7.5 million. The deductible amount is calculated using a tapering value formula. As you can also see, employers in this tier pay tax at a rate of 5.5%. If your taxable wages are above the upper threshold amount of $7.5 million, then you don't receive any deductible amount, and all wages are liable for payroll tax at 5.5%. I mentioned that the deductible amount is affected by the diminishing threshold for employers who pay between $1 million and $7.5 million. There are a couple of other things that affect the deductible amount. So these are employers who pay wages in other states or territories will get an apportioned deductible amount relative to the wages they pay in Western Australia. Employers who only employ for part of a year will get an apportioned deductible amount relative to the time they employ for. And employers who are part of a group will be affected by apportioning, so the designated group employer gets the threshold and any remainder is apportioned among the other group members. We're going to look at lodgement dates for payroll tax returns. We have clients who lodge their payroll tax returns at different frequencies. Monthly and annual return due dates are the same across all Australian states and territories, and WA allows also quarterly payroll tax returns. For employers who lodge monthly, your returns are due by the 7th of the next month. That includes returns lodged for July through to May. Your June return is due by the 21st of July. If you are a quarterly lodger in Western Australia only, you must lodge by the 7th of October, January and April, and by the 21st of July for the June quarter and the annual reconciliation. Finally, annual lodgers must complete an annual return and their annual reconciliation by the 21st of July. Reconciliation is completed by Revenue WA on your behalf. We'll look at this in detail in a minute. Now, a quick recap question. What will the payroll tax rate be in the new financial year if your taxable wages are $6.5 million? Just give you a moment to think about that. You've got the choices there of 5.5%, 6%, and 6.5%. Okay, so the correct answer for this one is 5.5%. Remember, if your taxable wages are above $1 million, the rate is 5.5%. Let's have a look at the annual reconciliation. This is the process of finalising the payroll tax returns for the financial year. This is to determine the actual deductible amount, actual rate of tax, and calculate the total payroll tax payable for the financial year. What normally happens is Revenue WA allocates an estimated deductible amount and applies an estimated rate of tax for you to use in your monthly or quarterly returns throughout the financial year. This is based on the estimated wages you provided to Revenue WA. Then as part of your June return, you and all of your group members, if applicable, are required to submit the required wage information by 21 July. We will complete the annual reconciliation process in mid-August to calculate the actual deductible amount and actual rate of tax to determine your payroll tax liability. Any credit or debit amount resulting from the reconciliation is due to the difference between the estimated and actual deductible amounts and/or the estimated and actual rate of tax. Your assessment advice that issues from 7 September will detail the calculations and adjustments and includes the due date for payment. Your assessment advice can be viewed from Online Payroll Tax Revenue Online that I'll take you through shortly. Now, when is the annual reconciliation due? 21 July. If 21 July falls on a weekend or a public holiday, then the reconciliation is due on the next business day. 21 July falls on a Sunday this year. Therefore, the due date for the June return and all required wages this year is Monday, 22nd of July. Please note that this application can defer in other jurisdictions. If you're an interstate employer, please visit the Payroll Tax Australia website for more information if you want to know your obligations in other states or territories. Now, another quick recap question. Choose which statement is correct regarding grouped employers. The options are only designated group employer, the DGE, can claim any threshold amount throughout the year. B, all group members can claim the threshold amount all year, or C, no one can claim the threshold amount throughout the year. Just give you a moment to have a think about what you would answer for this question. Okay, so the answer for this one would be A. Only the designated group employer, the DGE, can claim any threshold amount throughout the year. The end-of-year lodgement function in Revenue Online, or ROL, is a step-by-step guided process. This has been designed to assist users by ushering them through the steps to submit required wage information to Revenue WA, so we can successfully reconcile their accounts for the financial year. This is similar for all eligible users, with slight variations based on what they have to submit. End-of-year lodgement is not mandatory. Users can still manually submit all their required wage details by navigating through Revenue Online and lodging each of the details separately. However, it does make it easier for you by guiding you through the entire process. So who is eligible to use this function? This slide shows the taxpayers who are eligible with the green ticks. We have separate annual reconciliation webinar sessions for taxpayers who are not eligible to use the end of year lodgement function. These types of employers are the ones with an X on the slide and include local non-group employers, members of both local and interstate groups, but not the designated group employers, and designated group employers of a local group who lodge annually. These entities should lodge and modify wages using the Lodge Return and Modify Return functions. You can find these on the left-hand side menu of Revenue Online. You can also register and see times and dates to the annual reconciliation webinar sessions on wa.gov.au. The function to access your end-of-year lodgement is available from 1 July 2024. You can also access the Australian taxable wages and estimated taxable wages options on the left-hand side menu. You can only access the end-of-year lodgement function if the June return is your only outstanding return for this year. So if you're a monthly lodger, June is your only outstanding return, or this is your last quarterly return if you lodge quarterly. If you are the designated group employer, all group members must have lodged or modified their returns, so there are no outstanding returns before you can access the end-of-year lodgement option. If you try to access the end-of-year lodgement function with other outstanding returns, or if other members of the group have outstanding returns, you'll be prompted to lodge these returns before you can access the end-of-year lodgement option. You can lodge these returns using the Modify Return and Lodge Return options on the left-hand menu. So let's go through the steps involved in the reconciliation process using end-of-year lodgement. The first step is to lodge and pay the June return as you would do for other months. Clients eligible to use the end-of-year lodgement option may not necessarily have to lodge a June return. Rather, they'll only need to report a total taxable wage figure for each wage category of the year. The second step is to review returns and complete wage adjustments if there are any. All interstate non-group clients need to lodge Australian taxable wages for the 2023-2024 financial year. For grouped employers, the designated group employer is responsible for lodging Australian taxable wages. Designated group employers can lodge Australian taxable wages once all other members have completed the first two steps. This does not apply to local employers or local groups. If you are a designated group employer or an interstate non-group lodging monthly or quarterly, you need to declare the estimated taxable wages for the coming 2024-2025 financial year. The designated group employer is responsible for lodging the estimated taxable wages for the group. However, members will have read-only access to Revenue Online to view the group's estimated taxable wages. Please note that for groups, the estimated deductible amount will apply only to the designated group employer and the estimated tax rate will apply to all the group members. Employers lodging annually do not need to lodge estimated taxable wages. Please make sure that you check your assessment advice after the reconciliation is completed by Revenue WA and pay by the due date. Let's now look at Australian taxable wages and estimated taxable wages and why it's important you submit them. The functions in Revenue Online for you to lodge these are available from 1 July and should be lodged by 22 July this year, as 21 July falls on a weekend. For clients required to lodge Australian taxable wages, if you or your group's Australian taxable wages is not lodged by the due date, this will result in a nil deductible amount being applied for the financial year and the maximum rate of tax being applied to the total WA taxable wages. For clients required to lodge estimated taxable wages, if they're not lodged by the due date, no deductible amount will be applied for the monthly and quarterly returns for the following financial year. Let's look at Revenue Online now and the end of year function available to assist you in lodging your wages for annual reconciliation. Make sure that you log into Revenue Online, ensure all contact details are correct, including your postal address. This is especially important if you lodge and pay payroll tax on an annual basis, or if you don't log into Revenue Online regularly. It ensures notifications go to the correct person and address. I will demonstrate how to use end of year lodgement function if you're a designated group employer of an interstate group lodging monthly. Start by logging into Revenue Online and click on the end of year lodgement link to complete your process. Here you'll see general information about the annual reconciliation process and the details you need to provide. To proceed, you'll need to tick that you've read and understood the information, and then click Start. You can see at the top of the screen is a train track, which shows you which step you're in of the end of year lodgement process. The first step of the process is for you to declare or adjust your WA taxable wages and review to ensure your WA taxable wages declared for the year are correct. You can see which step you're at within the taxable wages section. On this screen, you can also see there are two options available for this client: option one and option two. A client that can see both options available at this screen can choose between either of these lodgement options to declare their taxable wages. Please note that quarterly clients and clients with a status change during the financial year will only see option two available. We'll first walk through option one. Option one allows you to lodge or modify your taxable wages for each wage category as a total figure for the year, rather than modifying each return period. We've selected option one, which displays the total taxable wages previously declared to date for each wage component in the previously lodged column. To view the details of the amounts in the previously lodged column, click on View Lodgement History. This will give you a further breakdown of the wages previously declared for each return period. To modify and lodge wages, enter the correct wage figure for the year for each wage component in the period total column. Ensure that you've included nil amounts, as all fields are mandatory. Once you have completed the declaration of your WA taxable wages, click Next. If you're an annual interstate non-group employer, your option one will look slightly different. So let's have a look at this. After entering your total WA taxable wages, you also need to declare interstate taxable wages. This will automatically calculate your total Australian taxable wages. Once they click Next, they will be taken straight to the end of year lodgement confirmation, as they don't need to lodge Australian taxable wages in a separate step and estimated taxable wages are not required. The end of year lodgement process is now complete. We'll now go back and have a look at option two for that designated group employer of an interstate group lodging monthly returns. You can tick option two to select this option. You can toggle between option one or two to lodge wages, but keep in mind that your wages entered will be disregarded until the wages are lodged. Option two allows you to lodge and modify returns for each return period. As you can see, it lists each monthly return rather than providing the total figure for the year as in option one. Option two reflects the existing screens you'd see if you selected the modify return function on the left menu and displays the taxable wages declared for each return period and breakdown of the wage components. To lodge or modify a return, you need to click on the return period to select it. Then press the modify button to declare and adjust wages and click save. This will be visible in the top right corner after you have clicked modify. Repeat these steps for any additional return periods to modify. Please note that clients will only have option two available if they lodge quarterly returns or have more than one status displayed in the first table for each reconcilable period. For example, if you're a local non-group employer for part of the year and became group for the remainder, then you'll only be able to use option two to lodge or modify your WA taxable wages. Press next to confirm the adjustments and continue to the next step. Option two also differs slightly for interstate non-groups lodging annual returns. After entering their wages for each component, they also need to declare the total interstate taxable wages. This is the total of wages paid in all states and territories excluding Western Australia. Annual interstate non-group employers will lodge their interstate taxable wages at this screen rather than the next step of the end-of-year lodgement process. Once annual interstate employers, grouped and non-grouped, click Next, they'll be taken straight to the end-of-year lodgement confirmation screen, as they're not required to lodge Australian taxable wages in a separate step, and estimated taxable wages are not required. So their end-of-year lodgement process is complete. Once you've completed your taxable wage adjustments using either option one or option two, you move to the next step, which you can see on the train track is adjustment summary. This step allows a summary of wage variances and tax variances resulting from adjustments to previously declared taxable wages. This screen also displays your account details information, including amount payable, the payment due date, if applicable, and available payment options. If the wage adjustments are correct, you'll need to click on Lodge to lodge the wages. This step shows a confirmation of the adjustments to your taxable wages for the lodgement period. Any lodgements or wage adjustments resulting in tax payable will require payment by the due date and is shown in the payment details. At any point in time, you can exit out of the end of year lodgement process using the exit end of year function button. We'll click continue end of year to move to the next page. We are on the second step of the process, Australian Taxable Wages Declaration or ATW Declaration. Before commencing this step, read the information on Australian taxable wages and accept. You can also skip if you wish to come back to it later or go back to taxable wages. The screens you will see are identical whether you choose to lodge Australian taxable wages as part of the end of year lodgement process or to select the Australian taxable wages link and lodge this separately. This screen shows you your group's current annual taxable wages for the financial period. The Australian Taxable Wages, or ATW, is the total of your WA and interstate wages. If you've not previously provided ATW, it will show as not lodged, which is the case for this client. To modify or submit you or your group's interstate taxable wages, select Next to progress to the declaration screen. If you're the designated group employer of an interstate group, members registered for payroll tax in WA as part of your group will be displayed, and the WA taxable wages they've declared in their returns will be pre-populated. You will not be able to adjust your member's WA wages. Any adjustments will need to be made by the member through their own returns. You will have to declare your interstate taxable wages in the interstate taxable wages field. That is, all your wages paid in all states and territories other than WA and the interstate wages of any other members of your group. If there are unregistered members of your group that employ interstate and do not employ in Western Australia, you can still declare their interstate taxable wages by clicking on Add Member. If a member is listed here but is no longer part of your group, you can submit a web inquiry to our office to advise us. Select Next to continue. This screen shows you a summary of the interstate taxable wages you've declared and your total Australian taxable wages calculated from the previous step. Please ensure all information is correct before continuing. If the Australian taxable wages are correct, select Lodge to confirm and submit this information. This is the lodgement confirmation page, which confirms the successful lodgement of your group's annual taxable Australian taxable wages. All the details are displayed here. Please check them carefully, and if they're correct, you can select Continue End of Year. Remember, at any point you can exit the EOY process and return to this, but you'll need to review what you've previously submitted. Now we'll move on to the next step, which is Estimated Taxable Wages, or ETW. Firstly, you'll see information and an acceptance page. To proceed, you'll need to tick that you've read and understood the information by clicking Accept. The next screens for the estimated taxable wages are identical whether you choose to declare the estimated taxable wages as part of the end of year lodgement function option or the separate ETW option on the left hand menu. You can see that this client has not yet declared any estimated taxable wages for the 2023-2024 financial year, which is showing a status of not lodged. If ETWs had previously been provided and are correct, no action is required. You can select Skip. In this case, we'll need to click Next to submit the estimated taxable wages. This screen is used to enter your group's estimated taxable wages paid in WA and, if applicable, other Australian states and territories for the financial year. As this client is an interstate employer, they must provide the group's estimated WA wages and the group's estimated interstate taxable wages. The system will calculate the group's total estimated Australian taxable wages. Once you've entered yours or your group's estimated taxable wages for the period, you need to select Next to proceed with the lodgement process. This screen shows the summary of information entered via the estimated taxable wages declaration screen. Please check if all information submitted is correct before proceeding. Select Lodge to confirm and submit this information. This screen shows a confirmation that your estimated taxable wages was lodged successfully. Your lodgement details are displayed, including the estimated monthly deductible amount and estimated tax rate that will apply. In this case, you can see the group's estimated deductible amount is nil, and the group's estimated tax rate is 5.5%. This is based on the estimated wages lodged for the 2023-2024 financial year. You then need to click Finish EOY to move to the next page. You are now on the end of year confirmation page. This summarises the steps you have completed, including your wage adjustment summary and your group's ATW and ETW. Scroll down and check if you've entered the correct amounts of both. If all the figures are correct, select OK. That completes the end of year lodgement process. Let's have a look at fringe benefits because it's a common question we get at annual reconciliation. It's important to note that you can't enter negative figures in revenue online. For those clients eligible to use option one of the end of year lodgement process, you can now include the total fringe benefits figure in the period total column instead of amending prior monthly or quarterly returns. If you're using option two, or the lodge modify return function, you can either modify individual return periods to reflect the correct total fringe benefits for the year, or if you need, you can reduce your fringe benefit figure in your June return. Please note that you don't need to submit any documentation to Revenue WA for any of the fringe benefit tax adjustments, but keep the records in your files for audit purposes. We also have a fringe benefit tax video on our YouTube channel, which goes through how to calculate the adjustment. We'll show you how to access this shortly. Let's now summarise what information you need when you lodge your June return. This depends on your employer registration type. Let's look at the local non-group employers first. If you're a local non-group employer and lodge monthly or quarterly, reconcile your June return before the 21st of July. And if you lodge annually, one return for the whole assessment year, you're required to lodge your annual wages on or before the 21st of July. As a local non-group employer, you must lodge and adjust your wages using the lodge return or modify return functions. If you're an interstate non-group employer, in addition to reviewing all returns lodged throughout the year and making any wage adjustments, you're required to declare the amount of interstate taxable wages paid throughout the assessment year as part of the annual reconciliation process. You are also required to declare estimated taxable wages if you lodge monthly or quarterly. If you are an annual interstate non-group employer, you will declare your Australian taxable wages in your annual return. If you're an interstate non-group employer, you're encouraged to use the end of year lodgement function to ensure all the required wages for the annual reconciliation are submitted. If you're a member of a local group and you lodge monthly, quarterly, or annually, all group members declare separately. Reconciliation will occur once all returns are lodged by all members. You're not required to submit Australian taxable wages as you only pay wages in Western Australia. However, estimated taxable wages are required to be lodged by the designated group employer if their frequency is monthly or quarterly. Designated group employers of local groups lodging monthly or quarterly are encouraged to use the end of year lodgement option. The designated group employer of local groups lodging on an annual frequency must use the lodge return or modify return function in Revenue Online to submit wages. If you're an interstate grouped business, whether you lodge monthly, quarterly, or annually, each group member declares separately. All group members must lodge their returns before the designated group employer lodges the ATW or ETW on behalf of the group. Designated group employees of interstate groups lodging on a monthly or quarterly frequency are encouraged to use the end of year lodgement option. After you and all your group members, if applicable, have submitted all the required wage information by the 21st of July, we'll complete the annual reconciliation process in mid-August. Check your assessment advice for any adjustments as a result of the reconciliation through Revenue Online after the 7th of September 2024. The screen shows an example of how to find an assessment advice. The steps are: select assessment advice on the left-hand menu, then select the assessment advice you wish to view, and finally click on View to open the advice. Any reconciliations performed after this date will appear as an assessment advice for the 7th of the following month, for example, 7th of October, 7th of November. Just a quick note for employers who employ for only part of the year. If you're a part-year employer, please make sure you contact our office and advise the start and cease dates of employment. The Revenue WA will manually process these returns and inform you of the outcome. Now that we've covered the important information on annual reconciliation, let's have a look at payment options. In WA, payroll tax can be paid via electronic funds transfer, BPAY or BPoint, or the Revenue Online client-initiated payment account called SIPA, where funds are debited from your nominated account. Please note if you have a credit balance, you can also request a refund via electronic funds transfer, or EFT through Revenue Online using the Refund Request link on the left-hand menu. It's your responsibility to provide us with up-to-date contact details, so name, phone number and email address. This year, we recommend you provide your postal address as well. Revenue WA will complete the annual reconciliation process in mid-August. Any debit or credit from the annual reconciliation will be issued and an assessment advice after the 7th of September. Now, I've got a couple of recap questions. So first one, which statement is correct about annual reconciliation? We have, it must be lodged by 31 December, is an opportunity to make any wage adjustments, interstate wage details are required if applicable, or the designated group employer must lodge total Australian wild wages. Just give you a quick moment to read that. Okay, so correct answer or answers in this scenario, we have B, is an opportunity to make any wage adjustments, C, interstate wage details are required if applicable, and D, the designated group employer must lodge total Australia-wide wages. Now, last question for this webinar. The penalty for failing to submit estimated taxable wages is the removal of the deductible amount. Is this true or false? Okay, so this one is true. The penalty for failing to submit estimated taxable wages is the removal of the deductible amount. We've covered all of the information on annual reconciliation.
I'm going to take you through where you can find more information.
So first up, we're actually going to go to our website at wa.gov.au. So this is a searchable website. If you're on a certain page and want to search again, I recommend clicking on the logo at the top here, which will bring you back to this search page. So in this case, we're looking at payroll tax. And we might just go into payroll tax and have a look at the payroll tax employer guide here. So it has a section on annual reconciliation. So if we click on number 8 here, it's got lots of information, including the frequently asked questions. So this will give you answer to anything that we haven't covered in the webinar today. Also on this page, you can see on the right-hand side of all our pages, it does have our contact details. So this phone number here will go directly through to the team that can answer your payroll tax related queries. You can also submit an online web inquiry through here. This allows you to submit documents as well if you've got anything specifically you need to have looked at. So this is a very handy resource for looking for your annual reconciliation information. It also has lots of information on grouping to ensure you are grouped correctly, as well as all the taxable and exempt components of payroll tax. So lots of information through this payroll tax employer guide. Now, I'm just gonna, as I said, go home by clicking on this again. And if I type in customer education, here we go, Revenue WA Customer Education. Now, this is our team here that conducts these webinars. If we click on Show More under Payroll Tax, you're able to see upcoming webinars. So overview, understanding taxable and exempt wages. So important way to be able to find if you want to find out more information rather than watching one of these recordings. As you see here, you can also join our newsletter here. So this comes out bi-monthly and we'll let you know if there's any updates to the processes, updates to the payroll tax legislation. So it's great to be in the know about what's happening. You're able to subscribe through clicking on the subscribe link. And you can also access from here our Department of Finance YouTube channel. So Department of Finance WA, if you search on YouTube, will come up with our YouTube channel. Now, as you can see here, we have a playlist completely of payroll tax. So it has information here, including copies of some of our previous webinars and information on fringe benefits, as we discussed in the session, which is very handy to use. We also refer during the session to the Payroll Tax Australia website. So just apologies there. Under the bar at the top there, if we go to Payroll Tax Australia, so this will give you all the information on the other states and territories. So if you are an interstate employer, you can get information on the rates and thresholds, for instance. If we click on rates and thresholds here,
gives you the information for the other states, as well as giving you a link into their state website so that you can have a look at the information required there. So a very important resource there that you can have a look at. All right, we're just going to return to the presentation here. Okay. So that brings us to the end of the webinar. I'd like to thank you for listening to us today. As I said, if you have any questions, please contact us through the website by either calling the payroll tax team or lodging a web inquiry. Thanks so much for joining us and enjoy the rest of your day.